the entire world that you live in is a criminal organization, period. Mm-hmm. And just like any cult or any gang, you don't have one gang. You got 1,000 gangs, and they're all vying for power to see which one can make the most money and live the highest on the hog off of the poor people who finance these organizations, have no idea in the world what they're doing. So my feeling has always been just open up the world to see what the real world of religion really is. Where did the money come from? Who are the people who started these different political and religious movements? And now you're getting into a dark spot that most people don't want to talk about. And, you know, when I was growing up, adults used to tell me, as a kid, I used to hear my adults telling me, well, that's two things we don't talk about now. We don't talk about things like that in polite company, politics and religion. And I thought I understood. The reason why we don't talk about politics and religion is because it might offend somebody. It might offend someone. Right. And then I started thinking, well, why the hell not offend them? It's about time somebody offends them and wake them up and tell you and show you how you're supporting organized crime. You're supporting child prostitution. You're supporting human deprivation. You're just supporting world organized crime. And we don't want to talk about that. Well, I'll bet you don't want to talk about that. And the governments have made sure you don't talk about that. Because that's not something we talk about, so that's not politically correct to talk about it. Why? Because the government is organized crime. It's a mafiosi operation we call the United States government. It's an organized criminal society, period. At the end of the day, that's the bottom line. And they are behind all of these religious movements, political movements. Organized crime is behind the drug trafficking. And where the drugs? We're told the drugs are coming from south of the border, from Mexico, from Colombia. All of those countries down there are Catholic countries, Vatican-run. Vatican-run Catholic countries are flooding the world with narcotics in Chicago. My God, Chicago is a world capital that most people who are intelligent and who can read and have woke up realize Chicago is a center for organized crime. Back before the days of Al Capone, Chicago was a den of thieves and organized criminality. And out of Chicago has come so many different religions and religious people and important figures in politics and Obama and all the rest of the Obama organization. You go back into the history, go back and do some reading about the history of Chicago in the 30s, 20s, 30s, 40s, and 50s, where Chicago was understood to be the criminal capital of America, period. It rivaled New York and the New York families. Chicago was a center of organized crime, which has given us Obama and the Democratic Party. And all you got to do is go on the web and type in Democratic Party and Mafia and watch and see how many articles come up showing you that the Democratic Party was in business with the underworld, with the organized criminal establishments in the Midwest. Everybody remembers back in the 40s remembers that the Democratic Party was involved all the time. You would read it in the newspaper. The Democratic Party or a Democratic guy running for Congress was found to have business and doing business with the mob, assassinations, killings, bloodletting. It's all criminality, period. At the end of the day, you're going to wake up and find out this whole world is lying in the power of the devil. It's lying in the power of the evil one, the Bible says. The scripture says the entire world is worshiping demons. And all over the earth, we're killing each other. And wars and violence. And we talk about how holy we are and how big our churches are and yet we're still fighting wars over the same old stuff. It never changes. And the reason why is because we don't change. We're always the same. The more we change, the more we stay the same.